So once you're done with testing, now we have the results in front of us and we have to determine what kind of treatment you need, if you need any at all. Of course, if all your metal levels are low, then we'll just say you don't need any treatment, moving on to the next topic. But pretty much every person we've tested has come back with more metals than they would probably like inside their body, and then we decide a treatment plan on that. It is important to know that these metals do not like to come out on their own with just detoxification support. They usually need drugs. So let's talk about the different drugs that are available. EDTA, or calcium disodium EDTA, DMPS, and DMSA. So EDTA is the IV version only. You can get EDTA orally and in suppositories and all that, but EDTA has very bad absorption. It is just not well absorbed. You can't get it orally, rectally, through your skin, whatever you want to do to it, you can't. It must be given IV. EDTA is definitely the most powerful version of the chelation. If you've drawn labs or blood or anything like that, you will see that there are EDTA tubes. And those EDTA tubes are designed to bind up the calcium to prevent blood clotting. And so EDTA is the most powerful one and the most widely used. But it can only be used IV if you want to use it at all. So I'm not a big believer in using it orally or rectally, anything like that, only IV. EDTA, as far as I can recall, can pretty much remove every metal on the board. And it's really good at it. It's really powerful. It loves to bind calcium and zinc as well. So in general, anytime you're on chelation, you are always on support. Currently, I'm using three main things to support people. A high-quality multivitamin. My two favorites are Phytomulti from Metagenics and Mitocore from Orthomolecular. I usually prefer the Mitocore in this situation because the Mitocore has more detox components. If we're looking at some of these other things, it's mainly a multivitamin, but it's just got a few components that help in the methylation detoxification area. So I normally encourage people to do the Mitocore. That's two capsules twice a day. The Phytomulti is just one tablet twice a day. But you also want to be on a magnesium glycinate. If you ever develop cramping or soreness or constipation, anything like that on your heavy metal chelation treatment, then you need to stop the chelation because you're getting into danger zone and you just want to replace those minerals and before you proceed with the next treatment. So remember, each time you take a dose of heavy metals, you're diluting out heavy metals, you're getting rid of heavy metals, but you're also diluting out and getting rid of beneficial metals. So as long as you're replacing with beneficial and not eating more lead, but each time you take a dose, you're removing the lead, then you will naturally maintain your beneficial metals and your bad metals will slowly get diluted out. So you must be replacing those metals. So once again, a good quality multivitamin like Mitocore from Orthomolecular. Second is going to be magnesium glycinate. It's around 120 milligrams per pill. I use pure encapsulations for that. You can take two or three a day. Really, the sky's the limit on magnesium. You can't overdose. You just poop your pants. So if you're getting constipated, just take more magnesium. If you're getting muscle cramps at all, stop the chelation, but increase the magnesium until the cramps go away. And then number three, you need to be taking trace minerals. There's multiple supplements out there. I'm currently using the Thorne product called Heavy Metal Support, which sounds a little confusing because it is actually a supplement called Heavy Metal Support, and it's got all the trace minerals. But I know Pure Encapsulations has the trace minerals. Basically, you're looking for that extra dose of zinc, selenium, molybdenum, all those small little minerals. So back to the drugs. We've talked about EDTA being the most powerful, and it can remove all of the metals. Now, DMPS and DMSA, they're called dithiol drugs, and they can remove most metals except for the ones I've underlined in orange here. So it's important to know that EDTA can remove almost all of those, but if you want to try to get rid of aluminum, cadmium, or nickel, then you need to do EDTA because DMPS and DMSA just aren't good at it. I would even suggest gadolinium, but I'm actually kind of testing a couple patients right now to see if we can get it out with DMPS or DMSA. So I don't currently know about gadolinium, but I know EDTA works for gadolinium, so that should get an underline. So your other options for DMPS and DMSA, if you have any kind of mercury overload, whenever you're doing EDTA for chelation, you must use a dithiol drug like DMPS or DMSA. And the reason why, this seems totally weird, but whenever EDTA binds to mercury, it seems to make a more toxic complex than mercury by itself or EDTA by itself. When they're combined together, they seem to be more toxic. And that's not seen, that's proven in science. But if you add DMPS or DMSA, it seems to stabilize that complex, or DMPS, DMSA has such an affinity for mercury more than EDTA, that it seems to balance that out and it makes mercury less toxic. So if you have high mercury on your testing, then make sure if you're doing EDTA that you are also taking a dithiol with each treatment. And I would even encourage you to take a dithiol drug in between treatments. So both of these drugs are called dithiols. DMPS is way better. The dose for DMPS orally is 500 milligrams. I usually dose it two or three times a week, unless someone's having side effects or if I'm worried about someone's kidney function or bowel function, then I will do it slower. Remember, you can't harm yourself by going too slow, but you can definitely harm yourself by going too fast. The dose for DMSA is similar. It's 500 milligrams, but the absorption isn't as good as DMPS. It's not quite as powerful. And so we can also do DMSA in suppositories in order to get better absorption. No one really likes that, but it does work. And it seems to be a little more affordable in suppository form, although that always seems to be changing. So DMPS also comes in an IV form. So whenever we're doing EDTA, if someone's got mercury or just wants more bang for their buck each chelation, then they would add DMPS IV in there to also get the more heavy metals out.